Guys, I am excited to share with you these Photoshop tips and tricks. Hi all, bonjour, hola, my name is Trish. If you're new, welcome. Shall we begin? So for the first Photoshop tip, if you want to enhance your photo, there are different ways of doing it, but there is one click that you can use to enhance your photo. So you want to go under your adjustments and click on your curves adjustment. Now you see that you have three different eyedropper tools. Click on the second eyedropper. Now the second eyedropper is samples in the image to set gray point. So click on that and watch what happens. Don't blink. Did you just see what happened? You notice that it quickly enhanced your photo. This is the before and this is the after. Put in the comments below if this was an amazing, mind-blowing trick that you have ever seen. Second Photoshop tip that I want to share with you is how you can take out anything out of your image. This time, we are not going to use the Content Aware tool, but I'm going to show you how you can use your Healing Brush tool. Your Healing Brush is located right under your eyedropper tool. And you have your spot healing brush, so you can click on that. So I'm going to click on my original image and watch what happens. I'm just going to paint over my subject and everything that pertains to my subject, release, and boom, everything is gone. Now, of course, you can still see a bit, which is still not that bad, but if you want to fix it, all you need to do is use your clone stamp tool. Now, that is the third Photoshop tip that I want to share with you. To patch up this area, you want to hold down options on your keyboard, select a point that you want to match, pick that. You see that on your cursor, it gives you a preview, and I can just keep going. And one more, hold down your options, select this area, and we can finish this off. And then you can paint back here. And you notice that as I'm moving my cursor, there is another plus cursor, which is basically scanning the area to fill that in. So you can see this is the before and this is the after. You can't even tell that there was a person in the photo. So guys, I've given you three Photoshop tips. So the next Photoshop tip that I want to share with you is how you can use the patch tool to either make a duplicate or to basically hide or get rid of anything. So I'm going to demonstrate first of all by creating duplicates for you to see what I mean by that. So you want to go back under your Healing Brush tool and then you want to click on the Patch tool. Now watch what happens. I want to make a duplicate of this. So I'm going to make a selection in this area and I'm just going to drag that onto this bolt, release, command D to deselect. I know, you're shocked. So you see that it makes a replica and even it patches it nicely that you can't even see how, you can't even see the difference between the patched area and the surrounding area. I'm going to repeat it in a darker area for you to see the same effect that we achieve. So I'm going to make a selection in this area and I'm going to drag that onto this area, release, command D, and it's perfect. Now, the other thing is if we want to do the reverse, you guessed right, it's easy. So if I want to get rid of this, I'm going to make a selection of the area I want to get rid of, and then just move that to an area where there's nothing, command D, and it looks good. So I can just use that same method to basically get rid of as many bolts that I don't want in this image. So I'm just gonna do that. And I wanna get rid of this as well. I wanna get rid of that. So I'm just gonna pull that. So the next tip that I wanna share with you is how you can set your image to a flat horizon. As you can see in this photo, the image is almost skewed to one side and we will like a very flat horizon. So to do that, all you need to do is that you want to click on C, enter, and you notice that at the very top it brings you different options, and you see something like a little icon like a bag would say straighten. So click on that. Now just draw a line directly on your horizon and just release, and there you go. So guys, leave in the comments below which tip blowed your mind.
If you're enjoying this tutorial, give this video a thumbs up.
So the next Photoshop trick and tip that I want to share with you are all on brushes. So we are going to go ahead and create a new layer to play with the brush. So if you pick up your brush tool, you notice that you can see around, you can see your brush size. The first tip is that if you don't see your brush size in Photoshop, it means your cap locks is on. If you turn off your cap locks, you can see your brush head. Mine was off, so you couldn't see it. Now, if I want to go ahead and brush, I can just go ahead and do that. Now, what if I want my brush head to be smaller? Now, there are a couple of ways to do that. You can use your right or your left bracket to make it bigger or smaller, and I can paint like this. Now, the other tip is that what if I don't want my brush head to be this hard? I want a soft brush head. You need to hold down your control options, and you can basically increase your brush head by moving your brush to the left or to the right. So left and right to increase your brush head. This way you can see the size. At the same time, you can decrease it if you want. Now, the other thing is, if I want my hardness to be at a zero, all you need to do is move your brush up. If you move it down, it will make your hardness 100%. If you move your brush up, it makes it a 0%, which makes it easier and you can get a smooth brush edges. I'm gonna go ahead and delete this and bring in another new layer. Now, the next tip that I want to share with you is if you want to change your brush color, you can use your color picker to choose whatever color you want. Did you know there's a much easier way to do that? Control options, command, and you can left click and bring up the color picker, and you can choose whatever color you want. I can go ahead and paint, and you can go ahead and maybe choose, let's say we want, and we can go ahead and paint in that. This is a shortcut to get your color picker to choose a color. The next Photoshop tip that I want to show you is how you can split your screen. So you want to go to your Windows and you want to click on Arrange. And the first thing you need to do is choose the file that you want to split. Now go back to your window, go to Arrange, and you can now have the split window activated. You can choose the two up vertical and it will split it in two. Now watch what happens. If I make any changes on this, if I zoom in, if I pick up my patch tool and I make a selection around, let's say this like that, and I move this right here like that, delete, and boom, you see the changes are done for me over there. If you want to zoom in, you just click on your option and then you can pan. And let's say I want to move my picture so I can basically cut this out. So what you need to do is click on H on your keyboard. It will activate your hand, which basically activates the pan, and you can pan and move your screen. Now, the other Photoshop tip that I want to show you is how you can rotate. You want to press R, and when you press R, it will basically allow you to rotate. So you see that even though this is being rotated, my other screen is not being rotated, but all the changes that I make will show up here. So I'm going to go ahead, hold down my options and zoom in like that. Now, to change your foreground color, what do? You hold down Control Options, Command, left click, bring up your color picker, choose, let's say, an orange like that. Now, the other thing is I want to decrease my brush head, so I'm going to make it smaller, holding down my control and options, which I've already just taught you. Now, I'm going to go ahead and zoom in and click on H to pan it like that. Now, I'm going to go back to my brush, and I'm just going to go ahead and do this. And release, and you see the change right there. I'm gonna take my flow all the way up, and I'm just gonna change my color to maybe a red like that, and I'm just going to paint that over, and boom, you see it. So if I want to make it even more straight, all I have to do is click on R, rotate it so it's more in a straight line. I can pick up my brush, or I can do the opposite side, this one. Pick up your brush tool, and you can go ahead and draw a straight line. It's easier. And boom, it shows up right here. And I can pan in, and you can see. It looks really good, guys. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this Photoshop tips and tricks. These are secrets, and these come in very handy. So please share with me in the comments below, which of these were your favorite? Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. So guys, till next time, please be safe, and I will see you back with another surprise. Yes, you know I always have something under my sleeves, right? Okay, so till then, guys, bye.